So hello everyone, welcome to Curious Human and I am Kshitij. Today we are going to talk about virtual reality. So what is exactly virtual reality? The simplest answer would be it's reality but virtual. But I will be explaining it in depth in this video and why it's the future or it's sort of a part of the future. And let's get started. So now let's talk about what is exactly virtual reality. Virtual reality is basically simulating reality in a form where our brain gets tricked into believing that it is actually the reality. So basically, let's take an example. Suppose they're watching this video right now. Can you see what is behind the frame? No, right? So in case of virtual reality, the frame is all around your eyes. So basically, it's like reality is being simulated in such a way that the experience all around you, including the sound and including whatever you see, is completely virtual, but your brain is tricked into believing that this is your new reality or the real reality. So now we will be talking about what are the implications of this and what is the advantage and why it is a part of the future, at least if not the future. Now let's talk about the good side of VR. So virtual reality can be used to explore places, first of all. So like, suppose you're on Earth right now, obviously everyone watching this video is probably on Earth. So you can experience Mars or any other planet like Jupiter or anything while just being at your comfort of your chair or your bed. So like, you can explore those places without harming yourself and getting a more realistic experience. So like, you can know more about that place, or maybe you can even go to another country, like go to visit a monument like Colosseum, the Eiffel Tower and stuff. So now let's talk about the point number two, or the second advantage, which I believe is treating phobias and traumas. So there have been quite a few cases of people being treated by virtual reality, like the fear of falling, fear of heights. Those phobias have been treated. There have been cases of people being treated by the help of virtual reality. So it's kind of very useful for helping people and the benefit of people. Another good point is that better learning can be improved and better work ethics. So, like, you can experience stuff because of the increasing immersion of this stuff in comparison to a normal video. It would be quite immersive of an experience if you just consider, like, suppose there's a physics experiment you have been doing. What would be better? Like, doing it in real life is one option. The other option is that you're just being told about it and you're just listening about it. The third option is this virtual reality case, like where you could like be experiencing it in front of your eyes and you could actually be conducting the experiment without causing yourself or anyone near you harm, unless you're scared of experiments. So now let's talk about the disadvantages of VR. So the first there are two big disadvantages we are going to talk about here. One is that it can cause people to like forget the reality, which is sounds kind of extremist right now, but we can talk about, if you have seen the movie or the read the book Ready Player One, which I would totally recommend you to watch / read, there's a clear example that most of the people in that movie or the book, if you have read, spend at least 10 to 20 hours of their life, majority of their life, in the virtual reality simulation. So it's like you're completely in the simulation and you're completely lost. So that's like a very extremist way, and like, people can use it as an escapism tool, which is sort of good, but it depends on the amount of usage for that, and anything excess is bad. And there's another big downside to the virtual reality is that people will stop socializing in real life and would use virtual reality. Although the experiences can be improved and people can like lose their fear of talking by using virtual reality, but still, it's not yet there that people are able to break the socializing issues. So the two main downsides are that people can get addicted or lose their socializing capability. Now let's come to the part that what is the current situation of virtual reality and where would it be in the future. Let's talk about what happened and what is the current scenario and what is the future of virtual reality technology, like seeing 5 years or 10 years ahead of the line. So the first thing about virtual reality will be currently be like, in 2013 the
it started, and there was a lot of hype earlier in the tech industry that it would like replace your phone, it would replace everything, it would be the future and all that stuff. But in reality, the hype flattened after like just a year, and like after Facebook brought it, then after that there was nothing much of an hype or excitement, and it just became a tech enthusiast kind of thing, because at that time either a VR was expensive and good, or it was cheap and kind of useless or bad. So like you had to trade off between those back in 2014-2015. Then in 2018 they just revealed their Oculus Rift, and then a lot of major titles were also coming back by that time. And the current companies which are big companies which are investing into this is Facebook with Oculus, Sony with their PS VR or PlayStation, and then you have Google with Daydream VR and Cardboard. Then you have Microsoft is sort of investing that line with their AR HoloLens. Now let's talk about another hidden person which is coming into the game right now, is Apple. Or at least we think so, or the if the rumors are true. Recently Apple brought a company called as Next VR. Although it's kind of strange to think, like what would Apple do with a VR company? They just bought a VR content community, a company. It's called Next VR. So it was a big acquisition, and one of the most major acquisitions. That in a time of a pandemic, like it doesn't make any sense, but it does. So what happened is that there's something known as the Apple AR and VR glass. So first we heard about this in 2018 that something is in underworks and it would come around 2020. But by end of 2019, it became clear that it would be postponed to 2021, the VR headset. And the AR/VR or something like that, is the details are not yet confirmed, but something is coming by 2021 or 2022 in by Apple, if all these rumors are true. Although there are a lot of rumors about Apple which do not come true or get delayed a lot. So let's talk about why it is now becoming more prevalent. First is big companies titles. So before 2015-2017, big titles of big game companies were not existing. There were only a few hand-picked titles from big companies. But around 2019-2018, things started to change. First came FNAF VR, Boneworks VR. There were a few very good titles which came. And the groundbreaking moment was when Valve, is a Steam, the one behind Steam, made a game called as Half-Life Alyx. Half-Life Alyx is like a popular series for those who don't know. Half-Life Alyx is like a third game, although it's a prequel to the original series. It was quite loved in the community of video gamers and content creators, which is why VR has started to gain a lot of popularity in the past few weeks and months. And which is why I personally believe that one Apple coming in the game and one Half-Life Alyx, like big companies are making the titles like big companies. It's really interesting to see this, like big companies getting into the game of making stuff for VR, making content for VR, and then big companies pushing hardware for VR. And one thing, whenever Apple does something, it becomes a norm to be copied by everyone. But Apple can do a lot of things. If Apple gets into the game and launches something like this, Samsung and other companies will obviously follow them, and a lot of innovation will happen. So honestly, I'm excited for this tech space, for this new upcoming era. Leave what your thoughts are, and I will catch you in the next video. Till then, stay curious.